In this video, let's look at the complements of a set and the complements of the intersections of two sets or three sets. Okay, let's say if you have a universal set. You have a universal set here. And inside you have an set which is A, set A. So if I want you to shade the regions of A complements, or we can say A prime. So means that you need to know first where is A. A is inside here, right? A is inside here. But now this is A complement, the complement of A, or we can say A prime. This means that it's outside of A. We don't want the A. So the region that we want is over here. Over here. Okay, so this is a region that we are looking for. Here we don't want. Okay, so it means that if you know where is A, you will know A complement, right? So now we go to two set or even three set. This A complement only involve one set only, right? I think you learned before, right? Okay, so now we go to intersection, the complements of intersection. If you have two sets, okay, let's consider this diagram first. You have two sets. You have set A and here another set, set B. And you have an universal set. Oh, the symbol is not nice. Let me write again. Okay. So if I want you to shade A in the set B complement. So first, you need to know where is A in the set B, right? A in the set B will be here, the overlapping area of A and B. It means that this part is inside set A, at the same time, it's inside set B. So this will be the part that, this will be the region that we want, but the question is talking about complement. Complements, it means that outside of this, we don't want this. So we need to shade here, outside here. Okay, so this will be the place, the region that we want, and so we need to erase it. Oh. Okay, so this is a region outside of this. This is A in the set B, and we want A in the set B complement. This outside of this region, we don't want this region. Okay, I still have. Let me erase this one. Okay. Okay, so but don't get confused between this. Let me give you another example. Okay, this one is A in the set B, the complement of A in the set A in the set B. How about now I give you exactly the same diagram? You have A, you have B, now you have A, you have B, and another universal set. Okay, now we talk about A in the set B complement. Now you don't have the parentheses here. So these two actually means differently. Okay, so how to do this one is actually very easy. We start from the left hand side, A, right? A, you shade A, whole thing. A. Okay, now you are doing this. And at the same time, the region that you have shaded just now must be outside of B. So why outside? Because you see complement, right? complement this B complement. B complement means outside. Outside of B. So means that this part we need to erase it. Okay, so this is the final answer. You look at the diagram, they actually differ. So this is, if I want to use a word to explain to you, right? This will be outside of A, intersect B. This will be inside A, at the same time, outside of B. Okay, these two mean differently. Okay, so let's go to these two. Let me explain for to you these two. Okay, look at this one. A intersect B complement. So first, you need to know where is A intersect B, the overlapping area between set A and set B. And it will be here, right? Here. But now we are looking for the complement. Outside of this, we don't want this. So we have the region that we want is here. Okay, so this is the region that we want. Okay, how about this one? This is maybe a little bit hard for you to understand. It's okay, let me explain it. Everything should be okay. Okay, let me give you some one example first. If let's say universal set is 1, 2, 3, and set A is 2. So what is A complement? A complement means that everything of here, everything at every element here, but except these two. We don't want the two because we want outside of the A, right? So we copy the rest, except the two. We copy this all element except two. Why we cannot copy two? Because two is inside set A. So we take 1 and 3. Okay, this is no problem, right? So how about now we try another one. This symbol is a little bit hard for me to write. Okay. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And now I have set A. Set A will be 1, 2, let's say 3. Set B, we have 5 and 7. Right? So if I want you to find A in the section B, what is the element? A in the set B is the overlapping area of A and B. It means that the element must be inside A, at the same time must be inside B as well. So they actually don't have any common element. The 5 is not over here, 6 is not over here, right? So this is an empty set. So if I want you to write A in the set B, complement. Everything you can copy like just now except the one inside the set, right? So this is nothing inside, nothing inside. So everything you just copy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, the same thing here. Now if I transfer all this data inside here, then it will be A is 1, 2, 3. Remember to put a dot here. So these two actually mean differently. If you have a set, you have a set and a number inside, let's say set A, number inside without a dot, and a number inside with a dot, they mean differently. If you write a number without a dot, it means that there are three elements inside this set A, but we don't know what are the elements. So three, we have three elements. If you write the number with a dot, then that is the element inside set A. Right. Okay, they mean differently. So now B is 5 and 6, 5 and 6. And the rest will be outside. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so A in the set B complement. This whole thing complement. It's all. That's why you see I should all region. Because A in the set B is an empty set. If you don't want to write the symbol, you can also use this symbol. Okay? So this one I think should be no problem. Now you have three sets but the same concept. A in the set B in the set C is a region inside A, at the same time inside B, at the same time also inside C. The overlapping area between among these three sets. So it will be here, right? It will be here. But now we are looking for the complement outside of this, outside. That's why you see I shade all this diagram except here, because we don't want here. This is A complement B, A in the set B in the set C. Okay? But we want complement that will be outside. Okay, so now let's look at some questions. Okay, let's look at these questions. Given that the universal set is this integers and from 5 until 15. So 5 and 15 are included. P is a factor of 24 and Q is a multiples of 3. And the last one, integers more than 10. Okay, find each of the following set. The questions does not ask you to, does not request you to draw a Venn diagram. But if you want to draw a Venn diagram, it's okay. So it's easier for you to get the answers. But when you draw the Venn diagram, it might take some time. So if you don't want to draw the Venn diagram, it's no problem as long as you can get the answer. Okay, so first let us list out all the elements for this all set. Universal set. So we have integers from 5 until 15. Okay, then we have P factors of 24. Factor of 24. Remember, all the elements of set P, Q, and R must come from the universal set. Okay, so 24, you want to list out the factor 1 times 24. 1 and 24 are the factor of 24. Then 2 times 12, 3, 8, 6. Okay, these are all the factors, but you cannot take all this answer. Why? Because 1, 2, 3, 4 are not inside the universal set. So if you don't want to think this way, you can just look at the number here. See, out of this all number, what number are the factor of 24? So you have 6, you have 8, and you have 12, and you have 24. Okay, double check. Oh, 24, we cannot take it. Why? Because 24 is not inside here, right? Okay, let me check again. So I have 6. 8 and 12. Okay, now we go to Q. So Q multiple of 3. Okay, you cannot write 3, 6, it's not, and so on. It's not correct because the universal set does not have the 3 here. So we cannot take 3. We have 6, 9, 12, 15. And then we go to R. Integers more than 10. 10 is not included. So it will be 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122, 123, 124, 125, 126, 127, 128, 129, 130, 131, 132, 133, 134, 135, 136, 14 and 15. Okay, actually, if you don't want to draw a Venn diagram, you can get the answer straight away. So if you want to draw a Venn diagram, you can draw it first. So when we draw a Venn diagram, first thing we need to consider any intersection between these two sets, right? Okay, now we have 12 here, here 12 here, and 12 also here. So it means that these three sets, they overlap each other at some place. So you can just straight away draw three circle. Three circle, universal set. Okay, so let this one be P, this be Q, and this is BR. When you want to fill in the element, first thing we start from inside, not from outside here, from inside first. So, 12. Okay, then we look at P and Q, the intersection between P and Q. The intersection between P and Q will be 6. 12, right? So we already wrote the 12. We only take 6. 6 over here. Why? I cannot put here because 6 is not inside R. 6 is not inside R. Okay, then I consider Q and R. Q and R. So let me erase all this first. Okay, Q and R will be 15, right? 15 and 12. So we write 15 over here. Oh, it's not correct. Q and R 15 over here. Okay, then we look at P and R. P and R. P and R. Look at this two. P and R. 6, 8 is not inside. 12. Oh, we have nothing inside here. So it's okay. We just leave this region blank. It won't affect your answer. Okay, now we go to P. We have 6, 8, and 12. 6, 8, and 12. And we go to Q. 6, 9, 12, and 15. 6, 9, 12, and 15. Then we go to R. 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay, double check again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So Q, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And last one, P, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, correct. So you notice that here we don't have anything here. It's okay. So don't forget to fill in the rest from 5 until 15, which are not inside here. You need to write outside. So yeah, we have 5. I write over here 5, 7, and 10. Okay, 5, 7, and 10. Okay, so if you don't like this diagram, you don't want empty space here, you can try to modify it. How about we draw another way? But if you leave your answer like this, no problem, you can get all the answers correctly. Okay, let me plan a little bit. Maybe I draw this way. Okay, then this one longer. This might be not really nice. Okay, let's try this one. P, Q. I think this is not correct. Okay, I need to draw bigger. This. So this is P, Q, and R. Okay, let me try. See, okay or not. This intersection will be 12. And 6 inside P and inside Q. Inside P, okay, this is 6. Okay, then inside Q we have 9. Okay, I can write here 9 and also here 9. And we have 15, Q and R, Q and R. But not in P. And we have 11, 13, 14, only R, only R. So 11, 14, 11, 14, and 13. Okay, so P, we have only P. Okay, let me double check again, see okay or not this diagram. But for an exam, you don't spend too much time on this diagram because this question does not request you to draw a Venn diagram. So even though you do not draw Venn diagram, no problem. As long as you can get all the answers correct. Okay, so we have 5, we have 7, we have 10. Okay, let me check. P, okay, so Q, 96, 95. Okay, R, 11, 14. Okay, so if you want to draw like this, also can. Okay, so later I will just use this one to help you to get the answer. Okay, now go back to this. P intersect Q. Inside P and inside Q. Even though you don't need, even though you do not draw this Venn diagram, no problem, you can get the answer easily. 12, right? And 6. If you have the Venn diagram, it's even easier. But when you draw the Venn diagram, you need some time. Intersection between P and Q, here, right? Ignore about R. So it will be 6 and 12. If you look at this, no problem, you also get the correct answer. 6 and 12. Okay, how about this one? Outside of this means the rest. All you copy except these two. Okay, I write the answer over here. 5, okay, you can take. 6, no. Why? 6 is inside here. We don't want. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, no. Because 12 is inside here. 13, 14, 15. Okay, these are all the elements for P intersection Q, for the complement of P intersection Q. Okay, if we want to use this Venn diagram, no problem. We copy the rest except these two. Okay, you will still get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 elements, correct or not? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, correct. So let's try this one. P intersect Q intersect R, the overlapping area between these three sets, inside P, inside Q, and inside R. Here, 12, if you want to use this Venn diagram, also can, right? 12. Why if you use this Venn diagram, why I cannot take 6? 6 is inside Q and P, but not in R. Okay, the 12 here is inside P, inside Q, inside R. So the answer is 12. So how about this? Okay. P outside of P, because you have a complement here, at the same time must be inside the R. Inside R. So actually you can think backward, is like you can think this way. Inside R, but cannot inside P. Okay. Inside R but cannot inside P. I can just consider this. If let's say I don't want to use this Venn diagram, I just want to get the answer from here. Inside R but cannot inside P. 11, okay, I can take 11. 12, cannot take it because 12 is inside P. 13, okay, 13. 14, okay. 15, okay. Okay, so if I want to use this Venn diagram, outside of P, at the same time, okay, let me check first, outside of P. Oh, สระ P at the same time must be in R correct or not okay outside of P at the same time must be in R means that if not in R not inside the R you don't want so these three right inside the R the rest we don't want the rest is not inside R so the answer it will be 11, 13, 14, 15 correct okay if you want to use this Venn diagram you can still get the same answers outside P okay let me try outside P these all are outside P outside P at the same time must be inside R then only can take it okay inside R this four can take it nine cannot nine is not inside R nine only inside Q okay so we get the same answer how about this last one P but cannot be inside Q at the same time cannot inside R as wellOkay, let me erase this one first. Okay, so how about I erase this? Okay, inside Q, okay, I do this two first. Inside Q, at the same time, must be outside, oh sorry, inside P, but at the same time, must be outside complement, outside of Q. So inside P, outside of Q, will be here, inside P, but outside of Q, we don't want the Q.Okay, let me draw it again. Inside P, outside of Q. Okay, so this is inside P, right? Outside of Q. Now I'm doing here, this part. Now we need to consider the third part. At the same time, must be outside of R.At the same time, must be outside of R. Inside of R, we cannot take it. So we need to erase those inside the R. So here is actually empty, right? So it won't affect the answers. The answer still is A. Okay, so if you don't want to use this Venn diagram, you want to look from here, okay? Let me show you how to do it. We look at P.We find Q complement first. Okay, Q complement means that everything from here except the 6, 9, 12, and 15. So 5, okay, 6 cannot, 7, 8, 9 cannot, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, let me check again.So 6, 9, 12, 15, cannot write here. Okay, so this is Q complement. So P will be, okay, let me copy again here, 6, 8, and 12. So P in the section Q complement will be the intersection between these two. Okay, so will be...intersection between these two will be 8, right? Okay, so 8. So now we go to R complement. Everything is inside here, you cannot write. So the rest you can write. So we have 5, 4, So 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 is inside R. We cannot take it. Okay, now we want P inside, P intersect Q complement, which is here. A intersect R complement, which is here. The intersection between these two. So you still get the same answer, right? So if you don't want to draw this Venn diagram, you also can get the answers. Okay, so for this video, I just stop here first and see you in the next video. Bye bye.